Hello and thanks for stopping by. If you are a new subscriber, Karibu to My Kitchen Space. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. If you haven't subscribed, consider hitting the subscribe button below here and let's grow the family. So today we're going to be making the perfect pizza dough, and without further ado, let's get right into it. So in our mixing bowl, we'll add 2 glasses of all-purpose flour, and I used this glass to measure my flour. This is a glass that carries about 150 ml of liquid. Then I'll add in my yeast. I'll be using about half a tablespoon of yeast, and I'm using this. If you're using the dry yeast, you have to activate the yeast by mixing the yeast and some warm water, but because I'm using this active yeast, I do not have to go through that process. Then I'll add in about a 3/4 glass of water, and this is warm water, and also I'll go in a pinch of salt. So it's time to knead this dough, and I'll be using my mixer, but you can use your spatula, mwiko, or your hand if at all you do not have a mixer. And so at this point, I'll go in with my hands. And I'll proceed to knead this for about 5 to 7 minutes till it becomes very soft. And then I can go in with my oil. So this is how I'm going to be kneading my dough. And I'll continue kneading this for about 6 more minutes till the dough becomes soft. I knead my dough by pushing it like that, then bringing it back, then pushing it again, bringing it back, and yeah. So I find this as the easiest way to knead my dough. And I think you should also try this. It's really easy. As you can see, the dough is coming together, and we'll continue. So at this point, I'll go in with about a tablespoon of and I'll continue to knead this till the oil blends in completely. So it's about 7 minutes, and I think my dough is ready. How you know your dough is ready is when it stops sticking on the surface and on your hands, like this. Yeah, as you can see, everything that was on my hands is now over, and that's how you know your dough is ready. So our dough is ready, and I'll add some oil in here. Then this is what I'll do. And I'm doing this to make sure that the dough is covered in oil so that it's ikauke. So I'll make sure the dough is completely covered with the oil. Then I'll cover this with my cling film. And then I'll put it in a warm place so that it can rise, and I'll be back. So because my kitchen is quite cold, I cannot leave it like this. So I'll cover it with my towel, and then I'll take it to the sun so that isichomwe directly na jua ndivyo isikauke. So in the meantime, let's make our pizza sauce. And we need an onion, 3 cloves of garlic, a piece of ginger, 3 tomatoes, oregano, a few ml of water and salt, and of course our vegetable oil. So we'll start off by roughly chopping our vegetables, and I'll remove this part of the tomato, then roughly chop it. So we'll put in our blender, of course. Na mwenye alisema ati nacheza blender yangu, I mean, this is not guaranteed, like tomorrow is not guaranteed. So tumia blender kwa uko nayo, wacha kuitumia, especially hawa watu wa bedsitter, tuache kutumia blender kama home decor. So use your blender whenever you can, utilize the opportunity, because I mean 2020 has taught us a lot. Tuache kuitumia kama home decor. Then I'll add in my oregano, about half a teaspoon of oregano. Then we'll blend this on pulse mode because I do not want the extremely soft mixture. I want it rough rough kiasi. So that's it, and this is how it looks like. Then for our onion, I'll do it a bit different today, and I'll slice this upper part of the onion, this one, and then we are going to dice it into very small pieces. So let's start the cooking process. So I've added a tablespoon of cooking oil, then I've added my finely chopped onions, and we are going to saute these for about 40 seconds. We are not cooking them till they become golden brown. Till when they start becoming translucent, you add in our mixture. And as you can see, we have chunks of garlic and tomatoes, and that's what we were going for. So we'll cook this for about 7 to 10 minutes. So as you can see, as you can notice, our paste has started to thicken. And we'll continue cooking this.
Also, you can add chili flakes if you are a fan of chili, but today in my recipe I'm not using chili. And the aroma in this room is quite amazing. Zinanukia poa sana. Kwanza the oregano and the ginger, they are smelling very nice. We'll cook this until all the water has evaporated. As you can see, it's doing very fine. So at this point, our pizza sauce is ready, and I'll add a little warm water to lighten the paste. Yeah, that's how I do it. I first thicken it, then I lighten it, and then now I'll cook this for about 2 more minutes, then it will be ready. So about a minute later and my sauce is ready. So I'll switch off the heat and I'll let this cool for about 7 to 10 minutes until it becomes warm. For our toppings, we have I'll be using my capsicum, my green capsicum, onion, smokies, and cheese, of course. So I love this recipe because hii inakuanga tu a quick fix. And yeah, it's a very low budget pizza recipe. And I enjoy because everything is usually readily available. Hakuna haja ya kushinda ukitoka kwa hao kwenda kutafuta ma ingredients huko nje. Then it's also not hard to make. Yeah, because haina complication mobs kupika manyama and stuff. So this is my low budget pizza recipe that I enjoy very many times in a week. Yeah, whenever I feel like pizza, this is the thing. So for our onions, this is how we are going to go about them. Unazi slice into half, then you tarnisha. So my onions are ready, and this is what I was going for, like heavy. So we'll put them there. Also, I refer to this as a low budget pizza because hatutumii pesa mingi pia kuitengeneza. Because for one, we are using about 3 smokies. 3 smokies go for about 45 shillings in a cuckoo shop, or if at all you buy the 10 pack from the supermarket, that goes for about 150 shillings. And then make sure it is the one that is written ready to eat, like you do not have to start cooking it or deep frying it. So these smokies are ready to eat, and one goes for about 15 shillings in a local cuckoo shop. And they are beef smokies, not chicken. Those in a cuckoo shop. So for our capsicum, we'll also slice them thinly, extremely thin as you can. So for this second style, we'll dice them into small cubes. Yeah, and now let's start working on our smokies. Make sure you freeze them for about 30 minutes before you start cutting them so that they can be easy to cut. And also for our cheese, you also make sure that you freeze your cheese for about 30 minutes before you start grating it. So we'll remove the edges. Then now we'll cut them into various shapes and sizes. For this one, I cut into halves, then cut diagonally. For this one, I cut them into semicircles. This one, I'll cut them into circles, but you can feel free to cut them however you want them, because it's a homemade recipe. Add cheese, then I tuck in. then hizi zingine sasa tunaweza tu ziweka tu like randomly. And we'll flood this with all these massages. Ooh. Yeah, unakumbuka ile siku yenye uliitishanga pizza alafu inakuja na tunyama twili. Alafu inakuja na cheese inatushana. Ni kama haiko, ni kama alikuwa anaweka, ni kama hawajisikii kuweka. Yeah, so this is the beauty of this homemade recipes. And again, for the third time, let me repeat. A homemade recipe, you're in control of what you want and what you do not want and how you want it. So you just flood your pizza with everything.
Yeah,
so this is what I was doing today. I was basically doing a low budget pizza. Yeah, because smoky tumes butter for 45 shillings because moja inauzanga 15 bob. The onion and the hoho, you had a kilogram of hoho at the moment cost for 40 shillings. So hapo hatujatumia hata kitunguu ya one bob. Then for hoho, hoho hiyo kubwa ni 5 bob and we've used like half of it. So toppings tunaweza sema we've used around 45 shillings plus the vegetables for about 3 shillings. Yeah, so that's it. Also I'm adding this. These ones hivi ndivyo ongeza tu tamu. Yeah, ndivyo at least you can buy to some cheese. And I think for this and I think I'll add my cheese. So a minute. Yeah, and so we'll just add more cheese. Yeah, we just flood our pizza with cheese. Utamu, utamu! So, I'll bake this for 20 minutes in an oven that has been preheating at 180 degrees. So people, as you've seen, making pizza at home is that easy. And now it's time to give it a taste test. It's grubby. Utamu ambao uko hapa. Oi. And this part of the crust, let me twist it. As you can see, there's cheese in here. Nina burutika vizuri sana. Yeah, it doesn't have to be plain because it's a home recipe. And I served mine with passion baridi. So so that's it for today's episode. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe if you haven't. Also share your thoughts, your comments and your ideas in the comment section below. And see you in the next one. Bye. Look at this utamu. Utamu tu. Utamu tu.